Yes. Hey guys, welcome to another Blender stream, and this time we're going to attempt to create this helmet. And so I'll add this. So if you want to get these reference images, I'll be adding a link in the description. Just check that out, and you should find the link there. And if you enjoy time-lapse videos, I'll be converting this into a time-lapse later and then upload it, but for now let's just go step by step so that those of you who are new to Blender can learn something. So let's first find a few reference images to work with and continue. Okay, let's see, let's try this. Okay. So I'm just finding a few reference images here that I can use. And as I said, if you want to get the reference images as well, you can find them in the description of the stream. I think the three are enough, but we could also use, I think, this one here. So if you have any questions, you can ask, but Okay, let's begin with adding a mesh. I think I will do this from here. And I think the reference images are the same size, so we don't have to worry about sizing them up to match the different views. So if there is any issues with the stream, please let me know and I see what I can do. Okay, I think we need to size these reference images a bit, because this side image is not the same scale as this one. So let's find a cube. So this should also fit from top to the bottom here. So let's go to the background and scale. Let's scale this a bit. Yeah, I think that's about right, because the top touches the bottom, and which it does for this side as well. So now that the reference images match up, we can delete this cube and let's begin. Let's see, how can we begin this? Okay, this is inside. See, I like starting with a very little topology as possible, so that if I make any errors, it's easier for me to make changes. Maybe we can just extrude the contours of this. I think it comes stand on clipping. Let me make a save here. Okay, and I think we can also get the contours of this side here. So I can just duplicate this vertex. It should be around there, and I start pushing it, extruding it to follow the contours. this. Okay, let me turn off clipping. Okay, so because this is the end there, it should be connected like so. And I think it should start something like that. Subdivide this. Okay. Now you see this R contour here, can get it, start working on that there, connect that there, and this. Add in more resolution now. Perfecto. You see, now we are getting the shape that we are going for. So we can also extrude this. I like working like this because it helps me add resolution where it is supposed to go, or where it is necessary, and avoid adding it where it is not needed. Okay. Can select this here. We can now start bridging some of these faces. Maybe let's also get this So these images are not aligning correctly because I think there is some kind of perspective distortion between these two images, and that's why you shouldn't really worry about making them align pixel perfect. So I'll add that detail, some of those details later. So let me just first get the main shape down, and then I can come back. I will come back and worry about those details later. Okay. Hello, Oleg Fedosel. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly, but thank you for coming in. Hope you're doing great. You can let me know if the stream is coming in well. I'm seeing it on my other screen and it seems fine, but I'm not sure if it's okay. So, thank you. Anyone who's tuning in, thank you for joining us. Yeah, you can say hello, just to make sure that, just to announce your presence, man. Thank you. Yeah, it is, man. It's actually just the shape is what is finished, but we still have a lot. I mean, the inside is quite not even started yet. We're just getting them. I'm just getting the base shape, and you can see I'm just getting this bottom part because you see it's two modules. There is this kind of like a shield area, but I first went with the base shape before I touch on the other extra parts of it, but I think yeah, we are almost there. So see, if you go with the, if you begin with modeling, extruding those contours that you see there, they can help you define your topology and where the loops should flow and everything, which will help you minimize on unnecessary use, or using unnecessary polygons. And I'm trying my best to avoid our triangles. Yeah, I think we have the base mesh almost done. We just need to do some cleanups. I think we can just have this go like that. I think we have the base mesh ready. We just need to, because it looks a bit like a cube in some areas, so we need to clean up. Let's see if I can get away with removing this loop. I'm just trying to make it more rounded. Sorry, the stream went off a bit there, but yeah, my internet is a mess right now, but let's try to work with it. Okay, so I think this is a separate, is it? Looks like a separate object from the base frame, but let's see how can we approach this. And this, we have this loop that goes around. Let's see if we added, if we just beveled it. Control B like that, and let's center the cursor maybe somewhere. Center cursor to selected, and let's use the cursor as the pivot point, and let's try scaling X and Y direction. So we have something like that. Maybe that is too much, so let's scale this back just a little bit. And let's delete this extra face here. We don't need that. And Let's just connect this. So we have that. Now we just need to make this sharp. And maybe we can just push this a little bit up. So we have something like that. For this here, so we have this loop here. What we can do here is, let's see, if we selected, because it comes, it starts around here and then ends around there. So what we can do is select these loops, subdivide, so we add a loop there. Now we can push it so that it bends in like this. Now what we should do, instead of doing that, you can just select it, go to the top, center the cursor somewhere around there, and around here. Let me make sure that I'm in the same view, so around here, and am I doing this right? Yeah, so something like that. Now let's just go to the top view. And I use the cursor as our pivot point and scale in the X and Y plane like that. And now let's see, we can connect this with a J. And can add a loop there, and we need to add another loop there, so we can just bevel this. But before we do that, this loop comes in like this. So we can do that. Okay, we are done with that. Let's see what other detail can we add in here. So we have this. I'm not sure if this is a separate frame. Let's see. Let's first maybe sharpen these angles here. Yes, first. How are we going to approach this? Let's see. If I extrude this like this, So this, I think this is supposed to be and we can add a loop there and a loop there, have these connected and this connected and that. Now we can sharpen this like that. So we'll come back to this part later. Let's first see how we can handle these other areas. Let's first hide this part so that we can work on this top part here. It seems there is some kind of distortion in the image, some perspective distortion, so we may not get exactly, we may not get it to match exactly, so, but let's work with what we have. Okay, so this image is not matching, so what I can do maybe, instead of following this exactly, I'm just going to eyeball it and yeah, see how it goes. So No problem, man. Thank you. Thank you for watching. I have to grind this just to get it somewhere. But thank you for watching. Ah, it's okay, man. But thank you for watching.